Drivers may have different preferences when it comes to how their cars handle, but there's one thing they all want more of.
Drivers always want more grip. You can get on the radio and say, well, go get me another bottle of grip. You know, the driver needs more grip.
Well, you can never get enough grip. It's probably not a very specific scientific term, but you want more grip.
The roar of the engines, the squeal of the tires, then the race to victory lane. It all says NASCAR. A race car is much more than steel, gas, rubber, and speed. A race car is a science experiment on wheels.
If you ask the driver what grip is, it's a warm and fuzzy feeling when he makes the corner that he's not going to spin out or wreck. If you ask the crew chief what grip is a thing that's warm and fuzzy and makes him sleep at night knowing he has it. I'm a tire man from back in the day, so in my opinion, grip is very simple. Grip is the amount of force that tire has to cling to the road.
How much frictional force, or grip, the tires generate is determined by two things: how well the tires stick to the track surface, and how much force is pushing the tires against the track.
The construction of the tire itself can actually create lateral force, and then finally the compound, the actual rubber that comes in contact with the surface of the road, provides grip through friction.
NASCAR requires all cars to use the same type of tire for each race. That means the only way to get more grip is to push the tires against the track hard. And that's where downforce comes in.
The downforce is a good thing for us because it provides additional grip. It basically acts to push the car through the tires into the track.
Well, people would be amazed at the load on a wheel on one of these cars. You could see 3, 4, 5,000 pounds of vertical load on the right front tire.
You can get downforce in different ways.
The two broadest terms would be mechanical or aerodynamic. And and both of those are very difficult to adjust during a race.
Mechanical downforce is the weight of the car pushing down on the tires. Making the car heavier may increase its grip, but it also makes the car slower. Air passing over the car creates aerodynamic downforce, which pushes the tires into the track just like the weight of the car does, but it doesn't add to the weight the engine has to accelerate.
It's like having weight on the car, but not having weight to carry around, and so it's a good free thing.
But how can air create grip? After all, it's just air. Air molecules are constantly moving. The average air molecule travels more than 1,000 miles an hour. A single air molecule doesn't do much when it hits a car, but as a car thunders around the track at 180 miles per hour, we're not talking about a few molecules hitting it. We're talking about billions and billions of molecules. Air molecules hit the car from different directions, but we're interested in the ones that push down. How hard they push down depends on how fast they're moving.
There's a well-known principle called the Bernoulli principle that basically is a result of the equations of motion.
Bernoulli's principle tells us that slower moving air exerts more pressure. More pressure on a given area means more force. Downforce is generated anywhere there's a surface for air molecules to push against. The whole body of the car creates downforce, but most comes from the splitter in front and the wing in the back.
Well, the splitter generates downforce basically with pressure difference. This splitter is essentially a horizontal shelf that allows the high pressure to push down on the front of the car. At the same time, under the car, the air is rushing under the car and there's a low pressure that's developed under the splitter.
A splitter literally splits the airflow. The air molecules that hit the top of the splitter slow down and create a high pressure region above the splitter. The air molecules that go under the car move faster and create a lower pressure region. The net result is downforce. Teams can move the splitter in or out to change the amount of downforce. Now, front downforce gives you front grip, but you need grip in the back too.
The rear wing is a different object on the car as far as generating downforce. With this wing, you actually have flow under the bottom of the wing and on the top surface of the wing.
Air flows more slowly over the top of the wing than under the bottom. Just like the splitter, there's a higher pressure on top and a lower pressure on the bottom of the wing, and that's where the rear downforce comes from. Teams are allowed to change the angle of the wing from 0 to 16 degrees. A bigger angle creates more rear downforce.
Many factors come into play during a race, but everything from grip to gas mileage all focus on one thing: getting to victory lane. You can't have speed without science, and that's why aerodynamicists are always working on new ways to make the downforce be with their car.